Welcome to the session of PCB Design using Eagle CAD Software. Learning outcome of the session. Before proceeding, let me ask you one question. What are the other softwares available for the PCB design? You can pause the video and write down your answer in your notebook. Resume the video in order to see the answer. There are different softwares available such as KiCad, Express PCB, Circuit Maker, etc. So what is the Eagle CAD software? The Eagle is a scriptable electronic design automation application with a schematic capture, printed circuit board layout and auto-router function and the computer-aided manufacturing features such as CAD/CAM. The Eagle stands for Easily Applicable Graphical Layout Editor and it is developed by the CAD Soft Computer GmbH. You can download the Eagle CAD software from the website www.autodesk.com. So in order to create the schematic, go to the file. There is an option of new and select schematic. So this is the schematic environment. So here we can draw the schematic. This is a toolbox where different options are available. Here is an option of the component add, where from where you can add the component to the schematic. So click on that option. So you can see the different lists of the components are available. So you can search for the appropriate component and select those components. Let us create one circuit diagram. I will create the voltage regulator circuit. So for that, we will need a voltage regulator IC. So search for V regulator. So you can see the option of voltage regulator here. That it includes the TO220 package, which will have a same configuration and pinout for each and every 7xx IC. So you can see the symbol here. This will provide you the schematic symbol and this is a symbol for the PCB layout. Let us add one component. So here I will add the component. So in order to deselect the component, you have to press the escape key. Now next component that we will need is the resistor. So I will add the resistor. You can see the different options of the resistors are available. So this option which is present in the brown represents the options for the surface mount device. So we have to add the resistor which is axial. Axial stands for the resistors having the lead component which is through hole component. Let us add at the output. Then press escape. Let us add one LED which is used for the indication whether the supply is available or not. You can search for the LED. So there is an option of LED. Let us add that 3mm LED. In order to rotate the component, you can press the right click of the mouse. I will add the connect the LED in parallel. Next component that I am going to add is the terminal, that is input and the output terminals. So for that I am going to add a pin head. So pin head, search for the pin head. You can have the option here. The pin head basically stands for the burr strips that we are going to, you can use for the connection of the wires, external terminals. So we will need two ports, that is one for the VCC and one for the ground. So let us add the two pin head. So one is for the input and another is for the output. Now in order to rotate the component, first select the component. So there is an option of move. Select that component and rotate the component. So if you want to delete the component, there is an option of delete here. So click on that option and click the component that you want to delete. Again, if you want to copy the component, there is an option of copy component. Click on that option so you can copy the component. In order to remove the component, you can use this option. If you want to move the components together in a group, then there is an option of a group. So select that option, select the component that you want to move, again right click and move the group. So all the move groups will be moved together. In order to connect the components together, we have the option of net available. So click on that option. So you can, I will add one net here. and I will add one net here. Now I will add the supply symbol. Again, go to the component, search for VCC. So there is an option of supply symbol. So add that option. So I will add the terminal here. So it will show you the warning of rename the segment. Click yes. Next, I'm going to add the component, this VCC at the input of the 7805 and connect it to the by the wire. Similarly, I'm going to add the ground. Again, go to the option add. Now search for the ground, that is G and D, and add the supply symbol. So I will add here, and one ground is here, and one ground is for the LED, and one ground is for the output. So next, connect the ground together. So in this way, you can connect the component. So this is the output terminal. This is connected to the output. This is the output connection. Now, if you want to connect this wire to this, you can use the option of name. So click on that option. I'm going to give the name to this wire as out and click OK. Now also I'm going to give the name to this wire as a out and click on OK. So what is happening? This is connected to this wire. If you want to see the what is the label of this wire, go to the option label, click on that option, and you can click here. So it will show you the name of this wire. Also, this will show you the name of this wire. So this is the total schematic diagram that we have drawn for the voltage regulator. In order to change the resistor name, there is an option of info. Just click that option and click on the resistor. So give the value of say 330 ohm and click apply and OK. So now we have created the completed the circuit diagram. Now this IC has doesn't have name because that IC specification is 78XX. You can change the name of the IC. Just go to the symbol information and click on that IC and give the name of that IC 7805 and apply OK. So the name of the IC will be changed. Now this is the schematic. If you want to draw the PCB layout, there is an option of board. So you can make a changes from schematic to the board. Click on that option. It will show you, it will provide you the warning, create the board from schematic. Yes. So this is an board. This is a layout where you are going to draw your PCB board. These are the components. We have to drag those components in this PCB environment. Let us change the dimension. I will take the dimension like this. Now if you move your cursor over this point, you can see the dimension here. Now let us first take the component, that is this is the 7805 IC. So this is a region for the heatsink. So be careful that you should not add any component overlapping with this region. So this JP1, what is the JP1? Let us see whether it is an input or output. JP1 is an input. You can change the name by information. Click on that and I will take it as an input. And JP2, let us give the name as a output. And again go to the board. You can see that input and output present here. So I will, if you want to rotate the component, just press the right click of your mouse. I will add the input here. Then I will add the output here. Now this LED, I will add the LED at this location and I will add the resistor here. Now there is an option of the raster nest. You can see the option here. So what is that option? It will take the optimum path for the two links. So you can see that the links are changed. If you rotate this, you can see that it will take the optimum path which is present in between these two links. So I will rotate this component like this and I can optimize that. So your component should be arranged in such a way that it should have the minimum overlapping in between the wires. Now you have the two options for the routing. You can do the routing automatic, you can do the manual routing. So before this routing, you have to make some changes in the design environment. So you can go to the option of edit. There are design rules. Click on that. There is an option of sizes. So the minimum width of the track is 10 mil. You have to change it to the 25 mil and click on apply. Okay. So I will show you first the automatic routing and then I will show you the manual routing. How to do the automatic routing? There is an option of auto. So click on that option. You can see the different options there, but we don't have the tops available. So I will click it not available and then click on OK. So what it will do, it will automatically route the components. So blue line represents the tracks and the green line represents the pads. Now how to do the manual routing? I will show you that. There is an option of route. So click on that option. So this is the input. Click on that input. It will show you the connecting link where you have to connect that. So here is an ending link. Again, go to this. You can move your mouse. Move your mouse, that track will move. If you want to change the shape, we don't need the 95 angle. We need the 45 degree angle. So just right click your mouse. It will provide you the 45 degree angle. Again, from this to this. Now from click here and the end will be at this stage. So click here. Again, this is the output, so the end will be here. So this is the starting end and this is the ending end. So click on this terminal, go to this, it will show you the ending path and just move your mouse over that path and click at the end. So this is the another path. So you have observed that in this way we have created the layout manually. If you want to increase the track size, so this is a track, and how to increase the track size, you can go to the option of information, click on that particular track, and you can increase the width of the track by this option. So in this way each track can be increased. Another option for the changing the track size is go to this option, width, and select this option. If you click that particular track, it will change the each and every track. So in this way, what we have done, we have created the schematic and we have created the PCB board. So these are the references for the session. Thank you.